Okay, this is the beginning of lecture 12. This lecture is going to be in two parts. I just want to finish up the story on air pollution. And this particular lecture, we're just going to talk for a few minutes about indoor air pollution. Up to this point, we've been talking about outdoor air pollution, and now we're going to talk about indoor air pollution. And then the second part of this lecture will be a quick exam review for exam two. All right, so let's turn to the document camera. Anything that's kind of stinky inside your house is probably contributing to something in the air that you should not be breathing. For example, incense. A lot of people burn incense in their home because for whatever reason, but actually you can see that even with the incense you're just giving off, well, you're burning it, so you're probably producing carbon dioxide, obviously, if you as you're burning whatever carbon-based material is in the incense, but also you're producing smoke. And the smoke is not a gas because we can see it. It's little bits of particles, the ash and whatnot, that don't get broken down all the way. And that you're just breathing in. And anytime you're breathing in smoke, it's not a good thing because of the particulate matter. It doesn't matter what the particle is, the particles themselves can cause problems in your lungs. Also, paint. Like if you're painting inside your house, you can smell that odor. Though that's due to the volatile organic compounds that are in the paint. And it's not going to be a problem, like you're not going to be producing a lot of ozone or something like that because of the paint, but the volatile organic compounds themselves can disrupt your normal metabolism, especially in your brain, and give you a headache just due to some of the oxygen is being knocked out, and you're breathing in these compounds that are getting into your bloodstream, and your body just has to deal with them. So paint and incense, whatnot, that would be considered indoor air pollution, or anything else stinky that you produce, or smoke that you produce in your house. If you have a wood-burning fireplace and it's not well ventilated, and you get smoke inside your house, that can be a problem. And as a matter of fact, now most people in the United States don't have a huge problem with indoor air pollution, but I'll tell you, outside the United States, for example, in India, I was just listening to something on the radio the other day on public radio, and they're talking about how in certain regions of India, people still use wood-burning stoves inside their homes. And so the women and the children will be in there in these little homes all day, cooking away, and just their house is just filling with smoke. And so what the World Health Organization is trying to do is get better ovens inside these homes that don't produce so much smoke, because just imagine the particulate matter that they're subjecting themselves to and their children. So, in the United States we don't have such a problem with smoke in the house, but in other parts of the world there are problems. So the stinky stuff you can sometimes see and always smell. There's also pollutants that you can't see or smell. And an example of one indoor pollutant, we mentioned this in Unit 1 when I was talking about natural radioactivity, but radon. Remember, radon is a decay product in the uranium decay series. And that is a pollutant that contributes to remember, most of the background radiation that we're exposed to in the world comes from radon, the ionizing radiation, and that can be found inside your house. If you live in a region where you have a basement, basements are dug into where there's rocks, and rocks contain uranium. And over time, as the uranium decays, there are always a chance that radon will be present. And in your home, it can build up. Now, the thing about this is building up. This is something, a problem with modern building techniques. I mean, in the United States, to try to have better energy efficiency, we've built homes that are very airtight. That is, the air, everything is sealed up really well. The windows are airtight, the doors are airtight. And so whatever air is inside your home or your office building is pretty much the air that's going to stay inside unless you have some kind of air exchange system. But if if it's not too hot or not too cold outside and you're not running your air exchange, then the air inside your house can become, pretty stagnant. And so the problem with the energy efficiency of the homes is that the air pollution inside your house can build up. One way that people deal with radon, for example, is they put a fan in their basement and they just have a little air exchange to just keep the air turning over in their basements, inside air, outside air, to keep the radon concentration low if they live in an area where there's uranium in the rocks. And you can test your home to see if you have a radon, high radon concentration just by buying a radon test kit. You can order one off the internet. Okay? So with all indoor pollution, the problem is the concentrations of the indoor pollutions can build up due to the lack of good air circulation, which is a result of, just trying to make our homes more efficient to keep the hot air out and the or the cold air out, depending on the season.